Suddenly, the majestic form of a wild creature caught Fenyx's eye. If Fenyx wanted to tame the beautiful beast, the mortal would have to befriend it first.
Why are you whispering?
Because I don't want to scare it away.
What are you on? Because can I have some?
To be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Fenyx, sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
That's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. Oh, if only I could travel to those most in need. But, alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault wedged under my largest root, which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer. So I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh! Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty seafoam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure sea foam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl? Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Fenyx. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard. Aphrodite, sweet and charitable. No more mischief!
Isn't that what you were aiming for when you married her off to Hephaestus against her will?
Hey now, it wasn't. I mean, she knew I was doing it for her own good.
Mm-hmm.
Locked all the Cyclopes away with the other Titans, huh?
Yes. He was afraid they'd overthrow him. There was a prophecy.
Bored. Grandpappy made the right call. Those things are an eyesore. Get it?
The birth of Aphrodite is a gruesome tale.
Nothing gruesome about it. Grandpappy Uranus and my deadbeat dad, Cronos, had a battle so great it severed heaven from Earth.
That's not all that was severed. During his surprise attack, Cronos descended on Uranus.
When Earth was severed from heaven, there was a great earthquake that knocked a pearl loose from its oyster.
Hang on, there was no...
The pearl flew from its oyster on land, and Uranus caught it and flung it out to sea with such a force that it caused the frothy foam to bubble. From the sea foam, Aphrodite rose, full grown, beautiful as that same pearl.
I can't take this anymore. Zeus, Gaia lied to you about how Aphrodite was born.
Oh yeah? Then tell me how it really happened.
And Kronos, they fought.
You can't be serious.
Fell into the sea.
That's...
because Kronos cut off his...
You're sick, Prometheus! Do not talk to me!
With the sea foam secure... Fenyx resolved to return to Aphrodite with the key to her freedom and the vault.
Returned, you sweet creature. Do you have the sea foam?
Right here.
Oh, aren't you good? Please, take my blessing for all your hard work. Now quick, pour the foam on my roots. The sooner I can move, the sooner I can expand my apple care.
Did it work?
Coming out of the foam, I was so... fabulous. No, there's too many godly creatures that need my help. It keeps me awake at night, just seeing their little beaks and bright eyes. And those noses, those quivering wet noses.
Yeah. happened?
Typhon must not like you. Though I couldn't possibly imagine why. Whenever anyone defies him, he sends one of his raids. And that raid delegates responsibility, as raids tend to do, to Shades.
So the warrior that just appeared wasn't really Achilles?
Goodness, no! The true Achilles is far more dashing.
Oh, you're telling me.
He's hiding in a lair nearby. Until he's defeated, his Shades will reappear on this part of the island.
Is there ever any good news?
Well, the sea foam worked and... I'm able to move my roots. One of them was actually blocking Achilles' lair. I can't help but the other three raids, though. Heracles, Atalanta, and Odysseus. Oh, you know what they say. Bad things come in fours.
No one says that.
No one says that.
Tough crowd.
What about the root blocking your essence? It's just that some people I care about have been turned into stone. So I'm quite keen to...
Nope. No. For some reason, that root is still firmly in place. Thank you for your concern. But what matters is I can start delivering apples. All the animals will be fed in no time. Let's get to it. Thank you kindly for all your help. Many happy returns.
But I... That was strange.
I can't keep standing idly by. Sorry, I mean busily preparing anymore. You have to bring Aphrodite back to her beautiful, snarky self before I go crazy!
By the gods, where did you come from?
Behind you? Does it matter? Don't worry about me. Focus on finding another way to shrivel that root.
So what? Saltier, more mythical water? Actually, wait. What about Aphrodite's tears? Didn't she cry at the death of Adonis? They'd be salty and powerful.
You really know your stories, kid. Her tears just might work. If you put them directly on the root, blocking off her essence. Now, where did Typhon hide them? You should search the vaults of Tartarus nearby. There are three crystallized tears.
All right. We have a plan, then.
Please hurry. Until Aphrodite is back to herself, who will I talk to about whatever this is that you're wearing?
What's wrong with what I'm wearing? And he's gone.
Macedonia. Ah! The smelliest of festivals, totally appropriate for Adonis. He didn't belong with Aphrodite, she was better than him.
Adonia was a celebration of women's self-expression. They would dance on the rooftops, bringing scented plants like fennel and cabbage to their parties. In the spirit of Adonia, isn't it Aphrodite's choice who she loves?
Not when it's rotten, like that smell.
And yet, the women of these villages let it waft from the rooftops, year after year. Maybe the freedom to make the choice is what matters. Fenyx would have to participate in the festival, to open up to Adonia, if the vault itself was to open.
That little turn of phrase, and you light up like a pomegranate tree. Oh, I see you, Prometheus.
You have your pleasures. And I have mine. Deep within the vault, Fenyx found one of the tears Aphrodite shed over Adonis.
I really don't think Adonis was worth all this crying. It was just a pretty face.
Ah!
Fenyx left the vault victorious, tear in hand.
Smelling only faintly of cabbage.
Fenyx, think. What would my brother do? Legiron would probably take on Typhon single-handedly, like when he bested the entire Spartan fleet. Who am I kidding? I'm in way over my head.